Science has provided so many answers to important questions that it's easy to overlook the deep mysteries of reality that remain. But keeping those mysteries in mind, at least in the back of our collective mind, is essential. It keeps us wondering, it keeps us humble, and it keeps us working for answers. First, let's look at biology. We really don't know how, in detail, the first living creature arose. What was the mechanism of life's origin? Even the foremost experts truly don't know. And has life arisen on other worlds, in other environments? We don't know. What about the strangest feature of life? Do I mean photosynthesis, or sex, or male pattern baldness? No, I mean the subjective sense of awareness. How does that happen? Subjective awareness refers to the having of experiences. What is an experience? What goes on in a nervous system to make an experience subjectively vivid for one person while it is objectively bland for everyone else? For example, consider the pain of a burn. It's easy to build a device that will respond to high temperature. A thermostat can do that. But we have no idea how to build a device that will feel the pain of a burn. It's tempting to say it just takes neurons, the neurons do it. But how do they do it? Consider the tiny roundworm called Senorhabditis elegans, C. elegans. Its brain has only 302 neurons, 302 switches. When C. elegans intentionally swims away from a hot environment, does it feel hot? Or is it just reacting to a higher temperature, like a thermostat? Nobody knows. Nobody even has any idea how to find out. It's tempting to say that the neurons just do it. Neural networks give rise to subjective sensation. But when we build a fake C. elegans with 302 electronic switches rather than neurons, no one thinks that the robot worm has sensations. How can neurons do what electronic switches cannot? No one knows. Right now, subjective awareness is a profound and important riddle. Let's move from biology to deep physics. There are deep mysteries there. In fact, they're so numerous, I'll just rattle them off. Why is ordinary space three-dimensional? Why is the dimension of time so different from three dimensions of space? Are there additional dimensions of reality? What laws of physics are truly fundamental that cannot be explained by even more basic laws? What constants are truly fundamental? Planck's constant? The universal gravitational constant? The steady increase of the national debt? What particles of matter and energy are truly fundamental? Strings? Loops? Spin foam? And what is this mysterious dark matter that constitutes 80% of the material universe? What about the so-called vacuum energy? Given this extreme energy of empty space, why is the universe expanding so slowly? How did the universe come to be and to expand in the first place? And what happened before that? These are incredibly hard, interesting questions. Perhaps the second hardest science question of all is, why is there something rather than nothing? Physicist Lawrence Krauss has written a fine book with that very title. But of course, Professor Krauss doesn't really answer the question. Maybe the hardest question of all is a question that reveals the fragility of all of science. Why is the universe consistent? Why do the same laws of physics apply day after day, moment after moment? I'm not asking whether or not some particular fundamental constant changes a little over the eons. Rather, why is anything the same from moment to moment? The laws of physics are called laws only because we observe them to be consistent. We have no idea why they are consistent, though. Accordingly, we have no scientific reason to believe that the universe and its laws will continue to be consistent. We just take it for granted that reality will be the same in the future as it's been in the past. Talk about accepting something on faith. But then again, we really don't have a choice but to adopt this faith. The alternative is not mere ignorance or emptiness. It is utter chaos, reality changing in every way at every instant. That the universe is consistent makes science possible. Let's study that consistency. Let's understand the laws, the regularities. That's what radical physics is about. But in the back of our minds, let's remember how little we know about the deep foundations of our knowledge. Profound mysteries envelop us as water envelops a fish. How many fish are privileged to appreciate the water?